Good morning, children. Children, your syllabus is completed. Lesson number 1 and 2 will come in your exam. So, this is a time to do revision. So, today I planned to give you revision about the term hardware and software. So, simply we will revise these two terms today. First is hardware and second is software. So, before starting hardware and software, I would like to tell you the working cycle of a computer. See, I told you in the previous videos that first of all, we give input to the computer. Then the computer system take the input from the user and then it process that data. After that, that data is converted into output. Output means result. So like this, we get result on computer. So the result go through two more steps, then it comes to us. And the device which shows us the output on the screen, that is mouse. Fine. So today our topic is hardware and software. So I told you, so today again I'm telling, the hardware parts are those parts of computer which can be touch, which can be see, means the parts of computer that can touch and see are called computer hardware. Like keyboard, can you touch it? Yes. Can you touch this mouse? Yes. Can you touch the CPU? Yes. Can you touch the monitor? Yes. Can you touch the printer? Yes, you can touch. So the devices which can be touched are called hardware. Are called hardware. I told you the examples also, like keyboard, mouse, CPU, monitor, printer, etc. These are the parts which can be touched. Now come on the term software. What is this? Software. Software is a set of instructions or programs, you can say. Software is a set of programs that can help the hardware to work. See, the work which user wants to do, who is using computer? Who is doing work on computer? So the work which the user want to do or want to get from the computer, that work is possible only because of software. Because only software will tell the hardware parts to work. Then only you can get the output. Fine. So these are some programs. So, with these programs only, we can do our work. So, the software is a set of instructions or programs. Okay. Children, very important thing is this, that hardware and software, both are interdependent. Interdependent, you know, means who work with the help of each others. Like hardware work with the help of software, and softwares are useful only because when hardwares will help them, when hardwares will be there, will be attached with the computer. So both are interdependent. If one is missing, we cannot perform any task on computer. So both are interdependent terms. Without software, a computer cannot work. Similarly, if hardware is not there, software is of no use. Clear? So, software and hardware, these two terms are clear to you all. Fine. Now, come on. One more very, very important part of this chapter, that is input devices. Children, listen carefully as it is a revision going on, I am telling you again about input devices. See, the devices through which we enter data and instructions are called input devices. The devices which are used to give instructions to the computer. Children, if you want to add two numbers like 5 and 4, what will you do? You will speak to the just tell to the computer by speaking, or you will type those number with the help of keyboard. You will type the number with the help of keyboard. So the two numbers like 5 and 4 will be given by you. Okay, and the plus symbol will also be given by you. You will enter 5 plus 4 is equal to. Then only your computer will perform addition. Then only your computer will give you the answer as 9. So, whatever you want to do on computer, for that work, you have to give instructions first of all. So, whatever the instruction given by you are given with the help of input devices. Like keyboard, it is used to give instruction. This is keyboard, used to give instructions. Fine. Now, the question is this, who invented keyboard? Who invented keyboard? As it is a man-made device, somebody has invented it. So, my question is, who invented the keyboard? So, here is the answer. Sir Christopher Latham Sholes is regarded as the inventor of QWERTY keyboard. What is this QWERTY here? QWERTY is, see, this keyboard is known as QWERTY because on this keyboard we have the alphabets in this sequence like Q, W, E, R, T, Y. That's why this keyboard or other common keyboards are known as QWERTY keyboards. Because they have the alphabet in this sequence. The alphabets start with this sequence. QWERTY. QWERTY. That's why it is called QWERTY keyboard. So, who invented keyboard? Christopher Latham Sholes. Who invented keyboard? Christopher Latham Sholes. The right answer is Christopher Latham Sholes. Now, see, the standard keyboard has 104 keys. Very important point. It is in your exercise also that how many keys are there on the standard keyboard. So, your answer will be 104 keys. Clear? Now, the question is the keys of the keyboard. Tell us the categories or groups in which the keys of the keyboard divided. So, we have four groups. How many groups? Four groups, like typing keys, means alphabet and number keys. Next, function keys, starts from F1 to F12. Then, navigation keys. Navigation keys consists arrow keys, home, and page up, page down, etc. So, these are navigation key. And number 4 is control keys. Control, Alt, Windows logo key and escape key. So, we have 4 groups. We have 4 groups of keys. Typing keys, function keys, navigation keys and control keys. So, you have to remember them. And you are to revise this part of the chapter only. Okay. So, stay ready for next revision. That will be in different manner. So, wait till that time. Okay. So, thank you for watching this revision video. I hope the input device, keyboard, it's the grouping of keys, and the hardware and software terms are clear to you. Thank you so much. Keep revising as your exams are approaching near.